And to all you people back in the Shire, turn your porch lights off because we're coming home with a trophy.
Hey there, welcome to SharkCast Pod, a podcast dedicated to the greatest sporting club in the history of the world, the mighty Cronulla Sutherland Sharks. This short, sharp review of the Warriors game at Shark Park is brought to you by Dyson Logistics, the Royal Motor Yacht Club in Port Hacking, and Jason Hawes at Cripps and Cripps Real Estate. My name is Sam Shinazzi, an OG from 2015, and I am devastated. What a devastating loss tonight, 30 points to 28, losing to the Warriors. In a game which will be remembered for Sean Johnson's last ever game. More importantly to me, Cam McInnes's 200th game, our last home game for the year at Shark Park. And one I thought we would really win, and even throughout the game, I didn't think we would be losing it. But then, right at the end, we saw it coming, the Sean Johnson show, and it's really kind of bitter for me to talk about. I'm not happy at all about this performance and particularly the ending. It does jeopardize that top four spot for Cronulla, most importantly. They are likely to finish fourth and play Melbourne week one of the finals. They've got Manly next week at Brookvale. Manly going to be missing Saab and Tom Trbojevic at this stage. But they have a lot to play for. The Sharks could slide to fifth if Canterbury win by a bit and we lose by a bit, but we'll get to that during the week. We'll hear all about those scenarios. But tonight, Sharks lose 30 points to 28 in front of a sold-out Cronulla Sharks points bet stadium, and that is not how you treat your audience. Just falling apart and not showing enough backbone and discipline in particular. We're 2 weeks out from the finals, and that's what you dish up. There was some good stuff, don't get me wrong, and some great individual performances. But as a team, when your back's to the wall, you got to show more than that. And the whole world could see what was going to happen. The whole world could see it coming. The turning point was Cale Iro being sin-binned. Whether you agree with it, whether you don't, whether you can see that that's the ruling they're making or not. The club just fell apart on that field. And then when he came back on, we got back into it, we went ahead, and then an error in the last minute of the game with us coming out of our own end from Jack Williams gave the Warriors a minute to score, and they did it. Yes, Jack Williams absolutely should not be making those errors, particularly in those moments, and the team should be helping him out in defending the line, and then we move on to next week and we learn from it. But just a real messy ending to a game that they should have won. They're up 22 points to 4. A couple of tries disallowed. There's a lot about that game that we could see as positive, but there's also a lot we can see as negative, and the negatives are outweighing the positives. Let's take you back to the lineups. We saw Dan Atkinson named in the centres with Iro and Stone Street. Nico Hines came in to play 5/8, Trindle at half. The pack was the same as it has been for the past month or so, with the bench of Jack Williams, Royce Hunt, Braden Hamlin-Welly, and tall Tom Hazelton. Pretty even start to the game. And then we saw two former Sharks tear it up. Sean Johnson obviously had a very strong game. He hit our left edge inside ball to Metcalf, former Shark, who sped away to score first, 4-0 to them. But then there was a lot of Shark attack, and it was great. A Cale Iro try from a Trindle ball. Stone Street with a long run after a great Blake Braley dummy half run. Tall Tom Hazelton off a Nico Hines ball under the posts. And they were in cruise mode. They were doing great. DWZ, our colleague Jardine's cousin, came to Shark Park and he scored in the 49th minute and then in the 54th minute. Nickel Clockstead in the 62nd. We had Montoya in the 65th. And then Dallin with the winning try in the last minute. Iro was sin-binned in the 61st minute. The Warriors scored through Nickel Clockstad Montoya in the time that he was off the field. So a real turning point. And the Sharks just have to fix up their discipline. I know the Iro one was controversial. The guy was falling. We've seen it all weekend. I get it. But we just got to be better somehow, you know. It's all very well to blame the refs, but we're putting ourselves in these positions. I know that on field, the referee said there was multiple occurrences of some sort of foul play, and that's why he went to the bin. Strange refereeing in that second half in particular. I still think you got to be better than that. We showed glimpses of being a top four team in that game. Down early, came back to dominate, down again, came back with the lead, and then blew it. The drop ball from Jack Williams changed the game as well. Super unfortunate for him. A lot of people on the pod really like his work. He's off contract. I don't know if that's coming into the way he's playing or not, but just not good enough from him. But as I said, the team needs to defend the next set of six and win the game. They went to the last tackle. They scored at the last tackle of the game. That's not a Jack Williams thing. That's a Sharks thing. And both edges were stretched tonight at different points of time. Some positives in the way the wingers played in attack, some negatives as well as the centers. Missing Jesse Ramian was huge. I love Dan Atkinson. I'm not convinced he's a center. And we saw the return of Nico Hines, and there was a lot to like. There are a few things that he needs to sharpen up on. I want to watch the game back and really study his game before I speak too much about him. But at different times, players wanted the ball, didn't get the ball. There was a lot happening out there to analyze, and I can't wait to sink my teeth into it some more. But hugely disappointing game. And I'm not suggesting or even think that the season's over. I think there's a lot more fight and a lot more twists and turns in this game. I'm just disappointed we fell for the whole Sean Johnson romance BS. I mean, last week, they didn't want to play for him. Tonight, they did in certain stages of the game. He had a good game. He had a good game last week, it has to be said. Seeing him carried off Shark Park, doing the haka, all the stuff going on. Tonight, they made it all about Sean Johnson. It was Cam McInnes' hour, his moment, and the team didn't stand up enough for him. And old boys' day, all those veterans in the house, from Gavin Miller to our mate John Docking, hundreds of players in the house celebrating being a Shark, and that's the way they finish. Man, we spoke about it on the show during the week. You got to make the most of these opportunities. I went into a bit of a American football TV kind of rant. I can't remember how much I edited it or not, but with Ben Harlem. And it's exactly what I'm talking about. Like tonight, when you make the most of these opportunities, win the game. Who knows where you're going to finish. You might finish second before you know. Now you can't finish second because you didn't make a tackle in the last minute of the game. Now I know there's more to it than that, but I'm just generalizing. A little bit disappointed we went away from the way we've been playing the last 3 or 4 weeks with the power game. Just looking at some of the stats, which we will get into throughout the week. As far as the forwards go, according to Fox Sports, who I work for and trust their numbers more than anyone, no one ran for more than 100 metres in the forward pack. Toby went close, and that's kind of it. Now, there was a large chunk of the game where we didn't have much ball. I think it was second half, maybe around the 55th, 60th minute for 15, 20 minutes. We didn't have much ball, so I can understand why the meters are down a little bit. That's not how you win finals games, and that's what we need to worry about. Probably the best player out there for me was Blake Braley, and it was good to see him continue his good form despite having his playmakers back in the game. Some of the young guys who are bringing a lot of attitude and really great skill, I think they need to tone down the kind of pushing and shoving attitude that they're bringing, the badass kind of vibe. I think it can work, but I think we saw tonight it can also backfire, give away stupid penalties. I just don't think it's necessary. We've seen Ronaldo this year kind of rein it in and then pull it out when he needs to. I think some of the younger guys could really do with putting that attitude into their defense, putting that attitude into their runs, putting that attitude into their mindset, because when it matters most, you didn't get the win. It's all very good being strong and having that bravado and pushing and shoving, but we didn't win at home. Last home game of the year to cement top four, possibly top two. Third place where you can play in Sydney to all your fans. Old boys day, and it just didn't get it done. Didn't get it done. It's going to be an interesting week. We've got Manly coming up at Brookvale. The storyline you'll hear is that Manly need to win. The storyline you'll hear is that we don't win much in Manly, but we have won in recent times, which is good, under Craig Fitzgibbon. So it's not impossible. They will be missing Tom Trbojevic. I believe Jason Sale will be out too. So huge two outs for the Sharks there, so to speak. And I'd really like to see us win. Go into the finals with some confidence. You don't want to lose two in a row and then go down to Melbourne. If you're lucky, go into a game like that down on confidence. I don't want to hear things like it's a new comp, we can turn it up, we can turn it on, flick the switch. It doesn't happen with this team. We need form, we need good form, get back onto it against Manly and roll on. Love to hear your thoughts throughout the week. We're going to do as many episodes as we can as per. SharkCastPod@gmail.com. We're on the socials. You can DM us there. It's the best way that we can answer your questions. Completely appreciate all your support throughout the week and weeks and years. It blows our mind. We really appreciate you all. Don't be shy about being in touch. Keep it respectful. Be as hard and be as heavy as you like, but keep it respectful, obviously, and we will talk about your opinions on the show. I don't know what else to say except I'm pretty disappointed. And I just think that we're just that little bit away from having that backbone, a little bit away from having that top two, top three, even top four feel about us. At times it was there tonight, and at times it wasn't. When the Warriors stretched us out wide, even when we had 13 players, so when Iro was off, I understood why we were stretched, but when he was on, and this isn't about him in general, they found us out. And I just was hoping for a lot more tonight. I told you all that I thought it was a lock that we'd win. I believed it in my heart of hearts. Even throughout the game, I still thought it was a strong chance we'd win. We got back in front. And then they got a little bit fancy in that last set, the Sharks. They had, what, a minute and a half on the clock after Metcalf missed the two-point conversion, which was great. He missed it. Seven tackle set, about a minute and a half on the clock. And what was it, third or fourth tackle maybe? Jack drops the ball. They're passing too much in those moments. They're not doing one-out hit-ups. They just had to do one-out hit-ups and then get the ball to Trindle, kick the you-know-what out of it, and the Warriors start their set on the 20-meter line with maybe, what, 25, 30 seconds to go. And then if they win from there, well, it's a different story. But to give away a scrum, 30 or 40 out with a minute left and then concede on the last tackle, it's not good enough. Not good enough. And let's hope that we can lift for the Manly game. I think we will. Like, I saw enough out there to think, no, we're a pretty good team. But then it just fell apart quickly as well. They did it for Sean Johnson. I understand that. But we need to do it for Cam McInnes and for all of our fans and for all of our old boys. And you know what? We need to do it for a top four spot, and we didn't do it. It's a theme throughout this club's history. It's not always that way, but there is a pattern. And most clubs probably have it, and we just focus on it a bit more. The vibe in Sharkland tonight was not good when they scored that winning try. And rightly so. Leave it there. Get into it some more. We'll talk to you all soon. Hope this hasn't been too much of a downer, but not happy. And again, you know, there were some great performances out there. So it wasn't doom and gloom. It was, oh no, this can't be happening. Up, up. Talk to you soon.
Tell your porch lights off because we're coming home with a trophy.